Today we are going to fabricate a short labial bow on a permanent dentition cast. So the things that we require are the universal plier. We also require a hard wire cutter. Then we require a 21 gauge round stainless steel wire, and we require a marking pencil or a marking pen. Now first we need to take a desired length of the wire. Roughly for a short labial bow, a 10 cm of wire is enough. So we need to cut that desired length. Now as you know that a short labial bow extends from canine to canine in one arch. So we need to do some markings on the cast where our bow would be resting and where our U-loops would be resting. So first we extend from the medial half of the canine. So this line we are drawing separates the incisal third of the tooth from the middle third. We divide the tooth into three parts. Now this line is separating the middle third and the cervical third. So dividing into three equal halves. So our bow would be resting at the junction of the middle and the incisal third. So this top line is where our bow would be resting. Now when we divide the canine into three equal halves, the medial third, the middle and the cervical, the distal. So our tooth, the U-loop would be resting at the medial half. And the loops would extend cervically 2 to 3 mm below the cervical line or at the crest of the bone, the bulge part as you can see over here. Remember that these markings help us to avoid any errors. Now we can first form an arch from this wire. Remember, we don't need to straighten up the wire. We roughly need that this wire component touches the outermost surfaces of the tooth in the arch extending from the canine to canine. So with the help of our finger pressure, as you can see that we first need to form an arch. Remember, there should not be any sharp bends and the plane should not be distorted. Forming an arc, and now we shall check that whether all the outermost surfaces of the teeth are touching the wire component. Now you can see that the central incisor and the canine are being touched with the wire component. So first we need to do some reference point marking so that we don't avoid any or we don't do any errors. So first we mark the central point, then we need to mark two points at the medial part where our U-loops would begin. So this would again avoid any errors. Now let us begin with the bending part. Remember, we should not distort the plane of the wire at any moment. So first we will form the loops, the U-loops. So for that we need to give a downward 90 degree bend at the medial part of the canine where we have marked the first point. Without distorting the plane, we give a 90 degree bend. As you can see that at the point we have given a 90 degree bend. Now similarly at the opposite point, for the opposite medial point that we have marked for the canine, we again give a 90 degree bend. Now this we have given a 90 degree bend and without distorting the plane of the component. Now let us check it. So our extension is from the medial part of one canine to the medial part of the other canine. This will help us in fabrication of the U-loops. Remember to keep the reference, that is the central point in between the two central incisor. And now we mark the extension of the U-loops on both the sides. Now engaging at the groove of the universal plier and the middle circular part of this plier, where we would be forming the U-loops and a bend towards us in one complete go. Pliers should not be changed at any point of time in a bend. Now you can see that we have formed a complete U-loop. Similarly for the opposite side, again we engage it in the central groove of this universal plier. Remember to keep the plane of the arch at the same plane. Now we need to bend it without distorting the plane. See, so we have to hold it very firmly and give a complete U-loop bend. Now remember that these U-loops should be in the same plane as we have formed the arc of the bow. So we need to do slight adjustment in this case. So this loop should follow the arch. This will help us avoid any errors. Now we can see the wired components. It is completely adapted and engaging into the embrasure of the canine, distal embrasure of the canine. Now we need to give two points where we will be adapting for the palatal adaptation. Now engaging it at the square beak of the universal plier and giving a 90 degree bend, as you can see that. Now we need to check whether it is going into the embrasure. Yes, it is going perfectly into the embrasure. Now we need to give another bend, now completely into the palatal aspect. So for that we need to give a slight marking at the free end. Now this marking and engaging at the rounded beak of the universal plier, we give a complete bend inside. As you can see over here, now this complete bend will help us in adaptation of the retentive arm at the palatal aspect of the cast. Now it is still not completely engaging. So what we need to do is, you have to remember this bend. So we need to give an outward bend like this. Now you have seen that we have given an outward bend. Now we can give a complete 90 degree bend at the extreme corner or at the embrasure point. Now this will help us in perfect adaptation and with the passive fit. Now you can see that it is completely adapted into the palatal aspect with the passive adaptation of the labial bow on both aspects. Now again going for the opposite arch or opposite canine, marking the embrasure point, giving first a 90 degree bend. Keeping the plane exactly same. Now this was first 90 degree bend. Now we need to hold it just 2 to 3 mm. We can first check it like this. If we are into the correct aspect. Yes, we are into the correct aspect. Now we need to open this bend. So slightly away from the embrasure point, we need to first open this free end bend before giving a complete 180 degree bend. So now when we have opened it, as you can see, now we need to give a complete bend as much as we can give with the help of round beak of the universal plier like this. And now we can check it on the cast. Remember to have a passive fit at every moment. It should not be having a spring like adaptation. Now we have a good adaptation at the palatal aspect of the retentive arms and the arch or the bow is completely touching the central incisor and the canine, we need to give a tagums now, or we can also give a 90 degree tail end bends, as you can see over here. Similarly, for the opposite retentive arm, we need to give a tail end 90 degree bend. So now let us check for the adaptation. So as you can see that our bow is completely at the marking and having a very passive fit. So these are some of the important aspects, steps, and some of the important things that you need to avoid. You have to do markings and need to follow these steps to avoid any errors. And in one complete go, you can fabricate a labial bow. As you can see, its adaptation. So this is the passive fit, as you can see over here. It should not have any springing effect. It should be passively engaged into the available slots or into the fissures, embrasures. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.